In this video, we're going to learn about the lettering tool, which is found here on your left-hand toolbar. And notice when I mouse over lettering, there are two options. One is for text, the other is for monogram. And in this video, we'll focus on the text tool, and I'll produce a second video for the monogramming tool. And to get started, I'm just going to travel to a new empty workspace and click on the lettering tool. And the first thing you'll notice is I'm given a tool options box that relates to lettering. And the first thing you need to do is type in the text you wish to embroider. So I will add my name to the screen by typing in Trevor. And then when I click on the workspace, it will place those letters. Now, all of the things that you can control come from the tool options. The font, the size, bold, italic, enveloping, placement, and special text, smart text with abbreviations. So we'll learn about all of these things in this video. And perhaps the first thing I'd like to show you is the difference between using the lettering tool and the lettering options and when we finished making lettering and we select it. So if I go to my rectangular selection tool and click on my letters to select it, notice that my tool options at the top simply has things like the size and the position, my mirror options. And I don't have any of those tool options like changing the font or changing the size. If I wish to change those settings, I need to return. So while this object is selected, if I click back on the text tool, that will return me to the tool options for text, which is where I could, for example, take it from 25 and make it 15 and hit enter, and it would reduce the size or change the font or change the placement, etc., etc. So this is how we can interact, because if I return to the rectangle selection mode, of course, now the lettering has your standard transformation options, like, for example, resizing or stretching our letters. So you're able to interact with your lettering options by using both the rectangle selection method for transformations or returning to the text tool for things like adding more text or changing the font. So I'll add my last name, which doesn't any longer fit on the screen. So, well, that's no big deal. I will scroll out, so zoom out, and then select that text with my rectangle selection tool and click and drag to change the placement so that it fits within the embroidery hoop. So that red screen in the background was simply letting me know that I had placed text that was going off of the screen. Now, I'm in my normal selection mode. If I wish to return to editing this text, I click back on the text mode, and that brings me back into text mode. And so at this point, we could easily change the font. And if I click on font, I want you to notice, and I'm going to scroll all the way up to the top really quickly and then scroll down. Notice that all the fonts at the top have a little zigzag beside them. Those are the fonts that were installed with the software that have been pre-programmed to work with embroidery. And at any time, if you stop and click on one, it will update the results of the stitches on our screen. And so these are the artistic fonts that came with our software. But scrolling down past them, and there sure are a lot of them, aren't there? I didn't take the time to count. But when you start to see the ones that have the TT to the left of the name, those are your Windows fonts that come with Windows or that you've added to Windows, because of course it's possible to download and install new TrueType fonts. And so in that way, it really makes the number of fonts that we have available for us to work with in our software almost unlimited, and we can convert the TrueType fonts into embroidery just as easily as we can work with the embroidery fonts. Now, something to notice when you're in this text tool mode, notice how every letter has a little red handle, and I'm just going to zoom in a little more closely so that you can see. If I select those handles, I can actually move the placement of the individual letters. So now this may not seem entirely appropriate for script lettering, but there's a lot of cases where we can create very decorative and interesting text effects by adjusting the placement of the letters. And in a lot of cases, it may not be about being decorative at all. It may be about getting the letters to look balanced on your screen. And so if we started a new text segment and put like A, V, M, N, O, and used a very block formatted font for that. Something that looked more like, oh, I don't know, maybe Arial. And sometimes when you look at things, it may seem like there's more space between the A and the V than it does between the V and the M or something. And so in this way, you can use these handles to adjust the spacing of the individual letters. Or you can move them to be interesting in decorative effects. Doesn't matter. It's up to you. So again, to achieve that, select your lettering, click back on the lettering text tool to expose the lettering handles. Okay, so moving along with text, I'll start some new text. So here I have my name. Perhaps it's too large, so let's make it slightly smaller. And let's change the placement from the standard horizontal placement. And when you're in the standard horizontal placement, this is when you have all the individual lettering handles. But we also have other lettering placements. There's on a line segment, on an arc, and on a user path. Now, on a line segment creates a line for the text that we've made, which is, of course, currently horizontal. Let's just zoom out and over a little bit. But what I'm saying is, here's the I get two green nodes that I can adjust for that line. So what I can do is I can use that to place this line in any place that I want. And it places the letters along the line, regardless of how long the line is. And notice that now that I've changed to be the placement to be on line segment, I've been given new tool options, such as reverse direction or text alignment, and the text placement baseline. So all good things to look at. The placement along the baseline. So notice right now that the letters lay along the baseline, and the letter Q has a descender, and the letter G, they come below the baseline. But you can choose how your lettering sits along the line, and the options are top, ascent, baseline, and bottom. So if I choose top, well, then it places the letters along with space along the top line. If I choose on the ascent, then it's going to place the letters along the closer to the top line, I guess. Baseline, the letters sit along the baseline and the descenders poke below. And then bottom, then it's more the descenders that are sitting on the baseline as opposed to the letters. And there may be times where this is helpful to you to be able to change. The text alignment is based on left right now. So here's my line and all the letters starting at the left. But I can make my text alignment be to the right or based on the center. Or maybe I want to force it to be full. And with full, notice that I can adjust now the placement of the line, and I can also adjust the letter spacing. So I can squish the letters together or I can spread them apart based upon a fixed line. And so that is when you use the placement on line segment. Now let's change that to on arc, and notice that it puts my letter, my name, along an arc. And here we have three green nodes. One is for the start of the arc, one is for the end of the arc, so you can make your arc as sort of curved as you want. And then the third one is for the radius of the arc, so you can make it more gradual. See if we make it sort of more gradual and then stretch it out. So you can really visually adjust the letters to place them upon a curve in this way. And this is where maybe you wanted to use, for example, if we were gonna do a lower arc for my name, and then you might wanna have a top ascent, you know, changing the baseline from the top to the bottom may change the way it aligns for you. So the last one was on a user path. And now I need to use the edit nodes to be able to get to see the baseline that I have. And so right now, if I right click over that baseline, I can add new nodes to it. And in this way, I can create kind of an any shape line that I want. And so you add nodes to this baseline to create the any shape baseline. And so it does take a little bit of fussing, but with sort of experience in creating points, even just from learning the digitizing tools, then we can learn to add these points to our baselines as well to create this unique sort of any shape baseline effect. And so again, that is all found by doing lettering and text mode. So also about lettering and text mode is the abbreviations, and we can also talk about enveloping. Now, enveloping is no longer available because of the fact that I've applied this text on a user path. You see, if I start, let's just let go of that text and say text for a new text segment and place down here the words Trevor. In fact, let's do all uppercases because they look nice with this. Trevor. And I'm going to select that and go to text mode for text editing. Now notice that it says envelope, no envelope. And this is what I was saying when I had this lettering selected. Envelope wasn't even an option anymore. And that's because I had put it onto a special user path. But for this lettering, I could choose, because the placement's still on the horizontal, to add an envelope. And with envelope, you get specific shapes. So yeah, they're basically numbered envelope 1, 2, 3, 4, down to 12. And so they create a visual effect. So if I choose envelope 1, see what it's done? It's taken the words Trevor and placed it on a straight baseline, but with a curve to the top. Now, let's see if I go to text mode again and try envelope number 2. And we have a value here of 25. And let's just see if I change it to 50, if it doesn't increase the amount of the enveloping effect. So you choose the envelope you want, and then you choose how much of that effect you want to have. And so each one of these, and I think the picture beside them are quite visual. So envelope number 5 would be kind of concave top and bottom. And with the value 50, there's almost nothing left of the letters in the middle. So maybe in this case, something like 10 would be more appropriate, or 20. but that is enveloping and how we can assign a letter envelope to our letter shape. So maybe this time 50 does look good. Enveloping. And of course, at any time you can clear it to have no envelope and reset it back to the way it was originally. Another thing we can control about the text is known as the smart text option, which interacts with our abbreviations. And I'm just going to go ahead and turn this on. And I want you to notice that when I turn on abbreviations, it shows me a list and it says replace this with this. And so the point is, sometimes we have things that are unique and we don't have any way to put them on our keyboard, like for example, a copyright symbol. And so by placing an open brackets, a letter C, and a closed brackets, the smart text will replace it with the C, the copyright symbol, or the registered symbol, or the trademark symbol. So let's give it a try. So what that means is, if we take this word Trevor and we type in, and what was it again? Open brackets, letter R, closed brackets, it substitutes it with the registered trademark symbol. And that's because we have smart text turned on. If I turn smart text off, then we would get, when I typed in open brackets, letter R, closed brackets, I would get exactly what I typed. Unless you turn smart text on, in which case, open brackets, letter C, closed brackets equals copyright symbol. And so again, you can learn more about the smart text functionality under abbreviations. And similarly, we could create our own new rules for the abbreviations. So with the abbreviations editor, you could come in here and say new and have, if I type the letter T with the letter plus and the letter C, put my name in. you know, and I believe that that would be possible. So not something that I'm currently doing, but this is the power of the tool options for lettering, and specifically the abbreviations editor. And so the abbreviations editor, I believe, would be specific to the different fonts. And so let's just test that out. If I create new lettering with a different font, maybe perhaps one of the ones that's built in, and it says Trevor, and then I put in brackets, R brackets, I still get the registered trademark. Now, if I look at the abbreviations for this particular font, yeah, they seem the same. So perhaps they are universal throughout all fonts. I'm not confident about that. I haven't learned that myself. But this is how you can use the abbreviations editor with your text. And that's a good segment about learning about creating text, editing text, and interacting with the text tool options.